everybody. It's good to be back with you again. This is our second week of Kids Connect at Home. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Auntie Jill, and I live in a place called Benoni, which is in Johannesburg. And I'm really excited that we've got friends from all over South Africa joining us today. So welcome. It's good to have you with us. We're learning about the fruit of the Spirit. And the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Now, I want you to imagine if you were an apple farmer. You'd have your fields with your apple trees. And what an apple farmer has to do is he has to put down some fertilizer and some compost so that the roots of the trees can suck up all that good stuff and be filled with good stuff. It's only when they've got good stuff inside of them that they can actually produce the apples, and apples can start to grow all over the tree. If there's no good stuff inside the plant, then it doesn't make any fruit. We're the same, you know. When we ask Jesus to be our Lord and Savior and he comes into our life, then we can start producing fruit. Now, I don't mean apples and bananas popping out from behind our ears or under our arms, but I mean that we'll start to have more love, more joy, more gentleness, more self-control. And just like people driving past would see the fruit on the apple trees, people should be able to see that fruit inside, because the Holy Spirit's inside of us. He's the good stuff, and the fruit can grow. Now, today we're going to be talking about the first fruit on the list, and that's love. And when you think of love, I want you to think of a strawberry, a nice bright red strawberry. Strawberries look a bit like hearts, and hearts the symbol of love. Now, I wonder, when you think about love, what do you think of? Maybe you think, oh, I love chocolate. Or maybe your friend sees you and goes, I love those shoes. Or you think of the boy in grade 7 that you think is just so cute. And you think, oh, I love that boy. But you know, love is more than just a feeling. Love that the Bible talks about is a doing word. It's not just a feeling word. It's not just, oh, it's a doing word. It makes us do things when we love somebody. I wonder if you could think about things that love might do. What sort of things does love do? I'm going to tell you a story today, and this is a story that comes from the Bible, and it'll help you to understand a bit more about what love does. This story is about a guy called Zach. Now, Zach was a very, very rich man. He had bags and bags of money. And Zach used to lie in bed at night thinking about his money and how he could make more money. Zach was a tax collector. Now, that means that he worked for the government, and his job was to collect the money from the people for the government. But he was a bit of a dodgy guy. He used to tell the people that they had to give him more money than what they actually did. And then he used to put some of the money that the people were giving him into his own pocket. And that's how Zach got so rich, because he was sneaking in more money from the people. So nobody liked Zach at all. He wasn't very popular because they knew that he was stealing money from them. Now, one day, Jesus came into the town that Zach lived in. It was a town called Jericho. And the people were really excited when they heard that Jesus was on his way, because they'd heard of all sorts of things that Jesus was doing in other towns. And so the people came out of their houses and they stood next to the street waiting for Jesus to come past. And Zach left his money collecting table behind, and he went outside as well to see Jesus. But Zach had a problem. Zach was a short guy, and so where he got to all the people were, he couldn't see over their heads. He couldn't see when Jesus was going to be coming. And of course, nobody liked Zach, so nobody made a space for him to come through so that he could be at the front. So Zach had a problem. Zach looked down the street and he saw a bigger tree down the street. And so he decided what he was going to do. And so Zach hurried off down the street and he climbed up the tree. And from there, he had a good view of the street. And so he could see when Jesus was coming. Now, when Jesus came down the road, he did something that made everybody's mouths fall open in shock. Ah. Zach was up in the tree. Jesus walked down the road. And when he got to the tree where Zach was, Jesus stopped. And he looked up into the tree and he said, "Hey, Zach, you come down. I want to come to your house today." Now, the people were shocked. None of those people even looked at Zach. They didn't like him. They never looked at him. They never spoke to him. And they certainly never went to his house. Those people didn't show love to Zach at all. But Jesus was different. When Jesus got to that tree, he looked at Zach. He spoke to Zach. He even used Zach's name. And he asked Zach, "Come on down. I want to come and spend time with you." Zach felt Jesus's love. Jesus really showed love to Zach. He didn't just walk on by and go, "Oh, I feel like I love Zach," or "Love you, Zach," and walk on past. Jesus showed Zach that he loved him. And that's what love does. Love's a doing word. Now, at the moment, we're stuck inside our houses. But we've got a lot of chances inside our houses to show love to people. Perhaps you can go right now and you can make a card and draw a really good picture and leave it on your dad's pillow to show him that you love him. Or you can really surprise mom by going to where mom is and saying, "Mom, can I help you wash the dishes?" I'm sure your mom will be so surprised by that, but you'll really show her some love. Maybe you can get on the phone and phone your granny and just see how's your gran doing in all this time of being shut in our houses. Or maybe, and here's a really good one, maybe you can say to your brother or sister, "What would you like to play?" And then actually let them play what they want and join with them in that game. There's a lot of ways that we can show love. You know what I'd like you to do? I'd like you to sit with your family now, call them all together, and get someone that can write to make a list of ways that your family could show love during this time. And then I'd love you to send it to me or send it to your pastor to show him what are your family going to do to show love during this lockdown. It'll really be great to hear your ideas. Love you guys, and we'll see you soon. Bye. There, everybody. Now, because we're learning about love and about strawberries this week, I've got a really nice strawberry craft that you can do at home. And this is what it's going to look like in the end. This is the one that I've just made. And so what you're going to need for this craft is you're going to need a sheet of red paper, a sheet of green paper, and a sheet of yellow paper. Now, if you don't have those colors of papers, don't worry about that at all, because I also made one that I just made with white paper. And so you'll be able to make one just like this with white paper and then just color it all in like a strawberry. All right. So to explain to you how you're going to start, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take your piece of red paper and you're going to fold it in half just like this. And then, once you've folded it in half, you're going to open it up and you're going to cut right down the middle line that you've just folded so that you've got two pieces. And then you're going to put those pieces of red paper on top of each other and you're going to fold it in half again, just like this. And then you're going to use a pencil to draw a kind of half a heart shape, just like I'm doing here, all the way around, really using most of the paper. Don't make it too pointy at the bottom. Make it a little bit curved in so that it looks like the bottom of a strawberry. And once you've drawn that shape, you're going to cut it. So you're going to be cutting through both the pieces of paper at the same time, and you're going to cut it to make the strawberry shape. And then you can open it out and you'll see that you've got two different strawberry shapes in front of you. All right, and then you're going to get your yellow paper or your white paper or whatever you're doing in the background, and you're going to put glue on half of the one strawberry, just like this, and then you're going to stick it down the middle of the paper. And then you're going to get your other strawberry and you're going to stick glue on the different half of that piece, just like I'm doing, and you're going to stick them right next to each other on the paper. And then you'll see you're starting to get the strawberry shape, just like I showed you in my finished one. All right, and then what you're going to do is you're going to take your piece of green paper and you're also going to fold it in half, just like we did with the red piece. And then you're going to use a pencil and you're going to draw just really a sort of semicircle, a kind of half shape around the bottom of, and you're only, then you can open it out again because you're only going to use the one piece to cut it, because you only need a top one piece of your strawberry. You don't need two tops of the strawberry. And then you're going to cut it just like this. And you're also going to cut just a little green stick as well, a little green strip that you can use for the top of your strawberry. Then you're going to put, you're going to take that piece that you've just cut, that semicircle, and use your scissors and just cut a few little zigzags into the bottom of it, a few little triangle pieces up and down, just like I'm doing here. And then you're going to put glue on the back of it and you're going to carefully stick it at the top of your strawberry. So you're going to keep the middle pieces standing up in the middle and stick it so that it's flat on the page on one side with the little pieces in the middle and then flat on the page at the other side. And then you're going to stick the little stalk in place so that it's up the top. And then you're going to take a black Kochi or a black crayon if you're using crayons, and you're going to do lots of dots, and you've got to do the dots over all the different pieces of the strawberry so that it's there. Now, if you're doing this with your colored paper, it's really just the same. Once you've done the cutting out of the white paper, you'll need to do the coloring in on the back and on the front of all your pieces, and the same with the green bit as well. And then that's it. That's really your strawberry, all finished. Thank you. Good morning, everybody. It's Sunday, and it's great to be with you today. I don't know about you, but at the moment, I keep getting my days muddled up. They all kind of feel like the same with us being at home. But I did know that today is Sunday, because Sunday is my favorite day, because I get to be with you guys on Sunday. And today, for the very first time, we're having Kids Connect at Auntie Jill's house. And so it's good to be here with you doing Kids Connect this morning. My family are going to come and join me just now. I had to get those boys up out of bed, get their pajamas off and some clothes on, get their hair brushed and their teeth brushed. Come on, guys, so that they could join us today. And what we're going to do is we're going to show you some actions for one of the songs that we learned last week so that we're all ready for Kids Connect this morning. So get your body up and ready to go. Get that body moving. Ready, guys?
The fruit of a spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of a spirit's not a coconut. You want to be a coconut. You might as well hear it. You can't be the fruit of a spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the spirit's not a coconut. Wanna be the banana, you might as well hear it. You can't be the fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. The fruit of the spirit's not a watermelon. The fruit of the spirit's not a watermelon. You wanna be a watermelon, you might as well hear it. You can't be the fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You can't be the fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. is not a cherry. The fruit of this pear is not a cherry. If you want to be a cherry, you might as well hear it. You can't be the fruit of this pear, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.
All right, and you get the idea with that one. Thank you.